Assalamu alaikum, dear learner. I am Kabir Sharfuddin Sheikh, Assistant Professor at Ali Alana College of Pharmacy, Akkalkua. I am here to explain about different plant growth hormones. So, plant growth hormones means the hormones which are responsible for growth and development of a plant is called as plant growth hormones. From this video, the learner should able to learn two things. First one is know the different plant hormones, and second is understand the function of phyto hormones. So these are the two learning objective from this video. So we will start first of all with the introduction. So plant hormones, we have already learned the definition, that hormones which are responsible for the growth and development of plant is called as plant hormones. So plant hormones are also called as phytohormones. These are the signal molecules. So this produces a signal in the plants so that it is able to grow and develop its different parts, like new shoots, apical shoots or roots and fruits also. And it is produced in plants in a very low concentration. So as we also know that in our human body there are different types of hormones secreted by our pituitary glands and different parts of our body. So the some examples of human hormones are thyroid stimulating hormones, growth hormones, luteinizing hormone, testosterone, estrogen, progesterone. So these are the different hormones which are responsible for development of our body. So likewise, some hormones are present in plant also. So they are also responsible for the growth and development of plant. So they are released or produced in a very low quantity, but their results are very big. So what are the different roles or functions of plant hormones? First of all, one is the growth and development of your plant. Then next is embryogenesis, means to form a embryo which develops into then shoots and roots. Then the regulation of organ size, then it can develop a organ by the process of mitosis. Mitosis means the asexual production of cells or diploid cells. Then it regulate a mechanism to defense against the pathogens, which it means it is able to kill the pathogens or avoid the pathogens. Then it is a stress tolerance also. Stress tolerance in the sense of water or in temperature. If the water scarcity is there, then it will tolerate that situation. Then reproductive development, it also helps in the reproductive development. Then there are different plant growth hormones. Then first one is the auxins, second gibberellins, then third one is cytokinins, next ethylene, and last is abscisic acid. So these are the 5 different plant growth hormones which are responsible for the development and growth of your plant. First of all, we will see regarding the auxins. So these auxins are responsible for the promote elongation of your apical shoots and the roots. So this is the main function of your auxin, and it is also able to give a plant as a phototropism. Phototropism means the growth of a plant in the direction of the sunlight. So it gives a direction to plant towards the sunlight. It is generally present in the apical shoots and then apical roots. So these are the two tops of your plant. One shoot is developing towards your sunlight and roots are developing towards your soil. So this is the structure of your indole acetic acid. There are different examples of plant growth hormones which are coming under the category of auxins. They are the indole acetic acid, then 1 naphthyl acetamide, then alpha naphthyl acetic acid, then 4 chloro indole 3 acetic acid, indole 3 acetonitrile. So these are the different indoles which comes under the category of your auxin. So auxin is responsible for your development air or elongation of shoots and roots. Then we will come to the next slide, that gibberellins or gibberellins. So generally the gibberellin is first of all studied or isolated or discovered by a Japanese physiologist or Japanese scientist Ichi Kurosawa. So up till now there are 137 derivatives of gibberellins were observed or were discovered. So one is the from all the gibberellins a skeleton is observed, that is gibben skeleton. This is a main skeleton, like we have seen in the beta-lactam. This is the penicillin, that is a beta-lactam ring is present. So likewise in this gibberellin the gibben skeleton is present, and then there are different derivatives were formed from this gibberellin gibben skeleton. See, the functions of the your gibberellin is breaks seed dormancy, means when a plant seed is in the sleeping state, then it is cultivated or plant in the soil, then it starts to grow in here, it grow its shoots and as well as roots. So it breaks the dormancy and it increases growth of plant, and next is the also elongation of shoots. But then next point is it develops the plant, in develops a plant means which first breaks its dormancy. So this process is called as embryogenesis, means formation of a embryo which develops further into a plant. Then come to the next, it is cytokinins. So cytokinins is plant growth hormones which is responsible for the differentiation and cell growth, or we can also called as mitosis. So in this it also affects apical dominance, means as we have seen a example of, we can see the example of the Christmas tree, only one stem is or only one apical shoot is growing and other branches are smaller, but one stem which is or the bark is the bigger one than the other branches, so it is called as apical dominance. Then axillary bulb growth, this is the gap between the plant stem and your leaf, so in that area a bud is formed, is called as axillary bud growth. And leaf senescence means it is a breakdown of leaf or detachment of leaf from the branches. So this is cytokinesis is responsible for your cell growth, differentiation, and it affects apical dominance, axillary bud growth, and leaf senescence. So this is a one examples from cytokinins is zeaxanthin. Then next to the ethylene. Ethylene is a gas which is produced by plant leaf or fruits. So this gas is able to ripe your fruits. It is used for the ripening of fruits. So it's given here, it's a structure, that structure is of the your ethylene. So ethylene is able to ripe your fruits. And then next function is inhibits flowering. Then next it promotes senescence, means detachment of leaf or fruit from the plant branches. Now come to the next, that is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is produced by the plant which are responsible for the closure of stomata. It delays seed dormancy, then it inhibits the growth of your shoot. Means abscisic acid is opposite to the other hormones which are responsible for the growth of your plant, but abscisic acid inhibits the growth of the plants. This video can be summarized by the growth of a plant from its seed to the fully grown plant and the production of fruits also. So first of all, for growing of a plant, we need the breaking of dormancy or seed germination. So it can be done by or regulated by the gibberellin plant growth hormones. So it breaks the dormancy of the seed and start to embryogenesis. So after the embryogenesis, seed able to grow the shoot and roots. So shoot will develop in the direction of sunlight. It is called as phototropism. It is occur or it is regulated by your auxins, and root develop in the direction of soil. So this is the function which will be regulated by your auxins. Then it comes next is cytokinins. Cytokinins will develop the plant apical shoots, apical dominance, axillary bud growth, then cell growth, then differentiation by its mitosis process. Mitosis means production of diploid cells, means exact copy of its parent cells, and leaf senescence. So then the next one is the ripening of your fruits, which will be carried out or which will be regulated by your ethylene gas. Then last one is abscisic acid, which will delay seed dormancy, then inhibits growth of shoots and leaf senescence. So this is the video regarding the plant growth hormones. Thank you for watching this video.